Hey, so I'm here at the lake today, and I just wanted to show you a few of my electronics. I got my Hummingbird Helix 10, my Hummingbird Helix 9. They're both side imaging models, but what I really wanted to show you is my MegaLive and my Mega 360 and the mounts. So I have my Mega 360 here, kind of up front, just in front of my graphs. And I have it mounted on a product that One Objective sells. It's made to go on any kind of track mount. And basically what it does is I can pull this out, and that'll let the 360 drop down right into position. Make sure it's pointed straight. And then that pin goes right back in there and locks it into place. And that's a sturdy mount, and it's been working excellent for me. So I can keep everything removable. I have the wires just coming out of the hole, and then the connectors are here, and then I have my excess wire that comes out of the top of the shaft of the 360, and then just nicely wrapped around here, and I have some electrical tape wrapped over it just to kind of keep it nice and neat. But it stows away perfectly and stays nice and neat. And then at the end of the day, I can just unplug these, unscrew both of those, and pop it right off. So if I ever don't need to take it, or just to put it on the trailer and run down the road, it doesn't have to stay on there. It's easily removable. So over here we have a similar setup. This is made by fishfindermounts.com. If you can see the logo there. But it's kind of the same simple deal. And I can pull this tab out, and it's actually spring loaded, so it stays in place. It doesn't come completely out. But you pull on that, this will rotate, drop straight into the water. And you have your handle here. You can turn it in whatever direction you need. It's all sorts of adjustability on it, so you can raise and lower the height on it. You can change the angle of the handle here. So like, I kind of have it pointed more up, which I found out that I really like. And then I also wrap some kind of grip tape around it to also make it give you a little grip and make it a little softer. But this one works really well, and I've kind of changed up the way they mounted it. Normally they have a big base plate you put it on, but I didn't have a big area. I had this track here. I just kind of modified it a little bit with some Yak Attack track bolts, and I was able to mount it perfectly right there. And it's been working great for me so far. It's way better than the DIY option I did. It's fairly expensive, but it's well worth it if you're gonna run a live on a kayak. So for the 9-inch screen, I have a mount that I kind of made. I wanted it to hang over the side of the kayak, so it wouldn't be in the way of my foot track right there, and I just have more of a clear deck. So I just took some starboard and kind of cut it into the shape so it would have two places to mount onto the track, and then it jetted off to the side. And I was able to drill holes and for the fish finder to screw into. So for the 10-inch, I'm using a ram mount right now. Yak Attack also makes a great mount. I moved away from it before I had this set up because I kind of modified it a little bit, because again, like this one, I wanted it hanging over the side more, and the way it was, it couldn't do that. So the way I modified it to have it off to the side rather than more centered above the track, it got pretty wobbly on me, and anytime I'd go to press a button, the screen would move back, and it was just kind of a little more difficult. But for this setup, the way I have it now, where it's directly above the track, I could very easily use that same Yak Attack fish finder mount, and it would work pretty well. And I'm actually thinking about switching back to it and trying it as well. But the ram mount has been working pretty good. This is the C size, I believe, which is like 1 1/4 inch. So if you're looking to get that, that's what size it is.
So the transducer for the graphs, the side imaging transducer on my autopilot, is mounted in the location that's built for transducers. I do have it mounted with a scupper style mount, so it's sucked up against the bottom of the hull. But you do have to be careful if mounting it on this kayak, because it does need a little bit of clearance for the side imaging to clear the sides of the undercut. But it's been working great for me. So basically the way I have the graph set up is I have a network box inside the hull. I have the network cable going from this graph to the box, from this graph to the box, and from my Mega Live to the box. So everything is network capable and talking to each other. I can share waypoints between the graphs. I can have one transducer hooked up to the 10, and I have my 360 hooked up to the 9. So that way I always have side imaging, and I have the 360 on either screen as well as the Mega Live. So whatever setup I'm doing that day, it's more than capable of displaying how I need it to display. This is the ultimate setup, so if you guys have any more questions about it, feel free to ask some questions, and I'll be happy to answer any more questions that I can. But hopefully this video helped you. I appreciate you watching, and I'd love it if you subscribe.